Hello, thanks for stopping by. My name's Gary. We play harmonica ensemble music here on this page, and so I'm going to tell you what's down below here on the website. One, we play two types of harmonica with everything we do. One is the diatonic harmonica. You want to own it in the key of C. Somewhere on it, it will be stamped with a little C. You probably can't see that, but there's a little C there. Also recommend you buy a harmonica in the key of G, which has a lower tonality, and that way when we hit the really high notes with one in the key of C, you'd be like, oh, I don't like that sound. I'm going to play it on my G harmonica. It'll sound better. The other type of harmonica we use is chromatic harmonicas. That's the one with the button. I happen to recommend this little inexpensive one called East Top Forerunner. It's perfectly fine for what we do around here. If you want to spend a little extra money, you can get one of the big bad ones. This is a couple $100. This one's $50, right? You can get a decent one of these for $40-$50. They do go down as cheap as $5. You probably don't want one of those. And if you get this big guy, you get this note. You're never going to play that note, but you get it. It comes free with your harmonica. let's talk about how to play harmonica and the sheet music we use around here. I'm going to put up a couple of slides. Number one, when you are getting started playing, the first thing you want to do, wash your hands. We want to make sure you're going to be sticking your fingers in your mouth, and you don't want to have your lunch from yesterday still on your hands. Second thing that I need you to do prior to playing is brush your teeth. It sounds like a very basic idea, but when you're blowing into your harmonica, whatever is in your face is going to end up in the reeds in your harmonica. So I really recommend before you play your harmonica, go brush your teeth, and then of course rinse your mouth out with water. Just get all the little stuff out of there, and you're going to need to be drinking a lot of water as you play anyway. So having a water bottle sitting right next to you is a really, really great idea. Next thing that you want to put on your agenda is good posture. So this cat has terrible posture. He's sitting all slumped over, and you don't want to be this cat. What you want to do, make sure your whole body is nice and aligned, your spine is aligned, your head's sitting on top of your spine correctly. We don't want to be playing like this, or getting your shoulders way up here. Any tension you feel is bad. So you're going to be just keeping your harmonica right here in your hand. Nice, even shape. And because we're going to be blowing air from our belly, we want to make sure that by having good posture, we also open up the airways in our lungs. Next thing, let's move on from the cat and breathe from your belly. Let me come back in and talk about that a little bit more. Important concept. As we go through life, we tend to, and you can feel yourself breathing from your neck when you do that. Right? It's not good. That's not what you want. The other one, a lot of times we talk about breathing from your diaphragm. And your diaphragm doesn't actually do anything. It's just hanging out down here. It's a muscle that moves up and down. And you feel this in your lungs. Where you really want to breathe from is your belly. You want to push this out when you're drawing air into your harmonica. I got it upside down. Let me try it this way. And then your belly just pulls out, air magically comes into your system, and it pulls through the harmonica. You don't have to blow hard. You just let your belly go out, and it ends up getting a nice tonality. Same thing when you're blowing into the harmonica, your belly will push in. Right, so you're just going to be using your belly as a bellows, really, to pull the air in and push the air out. Pushing your stomach forward to pull the air in, pulling it in to push the air out. If you work that, it will definitely make your tone much better than if you do it any other way. Next thing, as I mentioned before, inhale and exhale. Don't really think of it as blowing in and blowing and drawing air in. That's what all of the books refer to. But really, that's too much. You really want to just inhale and exhale as if the spirit of life is coming through your harmonica, and it will absolutely cooperate with you. Don't blow real hard. Don't suck air in real hard through your harmonica. You can bend the reeds that way, it's just not good. When we're first starting out, we want to get just a nice, smooth, gentle airflow going through your thing. through your harmonica. Now let's talk about pucker up here. Several important concepts in harmonica, but we play a melody here, and when you play melody, you got to get one note out of the harmonica at the time. So you want to pucker up, grab hole number four, pucker up, and blow into hole number four. If your mouth is too wide, you'll get more than one note. It's not bad, but it's going to be hard to get a clean melody out of that. So you do want to pucker up. Put the harmonica fairly substantially into your lips. Maybe not so much into your lower lip, but your upper lip should definitely be over the top of the harmonica. Get a nice clean sound. Same thing will happen when I draw air in. All right, so just nice and easy on that. Placing it pretty far into your lips. If you get multiple sounds, that's called a chord. It's not bad, it's just not exactly what we need at any given time. And so that business of puckering up is gonna be your first step in getting a clean tone out of your harmonica. Next thing that you wanna do, and this slide says, use your kissing muscles. You love harmonica, right? Inside of your mouth, think of kissing. There's muscles that's going on. Both your tongue is going up and down. Muscles inside of your cheeks and in your side of your mouth are doing things, right? And that's your embouchure, is what they call it. It's a hard word to say. What's going on there is those muscles inside of your mouth are helping guide the activities. And the same thing will happen with your harmonica. If you're fighting getting a single tone through, you need to tighten up your embouchure. And eventually you'll be able to play it rather loosely. We're lucky on harmonica, we don't have to have a super complex embouchure to get good sound out of the harmonica. As you get better, you'll get more sophisticated with it. But we want to use those kissing muscles to help guide the air through a single hole. And then of course pull it through. And I'm using my inner kissing muscles just to make sure the air is doing what it's supposed to do. You'll also ultimately use those muscles to bend notes. You can hear that meow sound. What's going on there? I'm still just drawing air through the single hole, but I'm tightening my muscles and then loosening them a little bit, pulling my tongue up and then dropping the tongue just a little bit. So that's a long-term project, and that's what would separate you from being a typical harmonica player to being a pretty good harmonica player, is how well you use your kissing muscles. All right, moving on. Next thing, between every note, I want you to say two, okay? And so if you're blowing, my tongue is just hitting the roof of my mouth. Same thing with draws. Between every note, just have your tongue touch the roof of your mouth, and that stops the previous note and gets you ready to start your next note. Over time, you'll get where sometimes you won't do a two between every note, but when you first start, definitely say two between every single note, and it'll just make it sound better. That cat's tongue is too far out to say two. Next, how you hold the harmonica. There's a pretty good graphic here, I think. My left hand is holding right over the harmonica, and notice my knuckle is right above hole number four, and then my right hand is held around the back to make a wah-wah sound. And so this is what I'm doing. I've got this here. Okay, just what I'm holding, just like it's a, I don't know, they say hold it like a sandwich. I've never held a sandwich this way. Knuckle above hole number four. That way, as you're playing along, and your lips will kind of get used to hole number four is always right there. And then this hand serves as sort of a wah-wah mechanism. So that's what you want to do, and just hold like that. Use this to help make the sound bigger or smaller. Next up on our list of things to think about as you're getting ready to play, move your hands, not your face. I love this graphic. You know, you have to think about it for a minute. Really what we're doing here, when we're playing, we want our hands to go back and forth like this. We don't want to be moving our face back and forth because it affects the way you're attacking the harmonica. And if you're blowing sideways and stuff, you don't get the same quality tone. Whereas if you just are moving your hands back and forth, your tone can continue to be straight. Your posture can continue to be good, and that's what you're working on. All right, a couple more slides. Next one, this talks about the sheet music that we have on the site. And so on the website, you're going to find tons and tons of sheet music. If it says on the harmonica line, blow four, that means you're going to blow through hole number four. If it says minus four, that means you're going to draw, you're going to suck air through hole number four. And then for the chromatic music, the stuff that's played on the more advanced harmonica, you'll see a star after that. And that means that you're going to push the button in. I'm going to blow through hole number four and push the button in at the same time. And of course, a minus with the star on it means draw air through hole number four while pushing the button. And so that's what's going on. And again, let me show you the difference between the harmonicas. On this little guy, there's no button, right? So we just play. And I didn't hold it right after that. If you use this. Okay. On this one, if you use the button, you got choices. I will blow through hole four first and draw. If I hold the button down, okay. And you get different tones based on whether the button is pushed in or not. That's the cool part about chromatic harmonicas. You got a lot bigger number of notes that you can make on one of those. All right, next up, next slide, we'll talk about the sheet music in more specifics. You'll have lots of lines on the sheet music we use around here. We play harmonica primarily, but we want you to be able to go play with other people. Because nobody's really interested in listening to you play solo harmonica, it's just not really a thing usually. We have a couple of guys on the planet who do it, but for the most part, it's not really a thing right now. You playing with other people is a thing. And so on the music, you will see chord notations for guitar. I usually put on a ukulele chord notations on some of the less complex songs. Standard notation, that's for singers, for piano players. And also, if you decide to take harmonica seriously, you will start to be able to read from the standard notation straight onto your harmonica. I always include lyrics. I get them close. I don't spend a ton of time worrying about them, but they're pretty close. Harmonic entablature, that's your line. And this particular line here, it says seven. That means you're going to blow seven. Then a minus six star, that means this is on chromatic harmonica. You're going to draw through hole number six with the button pushed in. You're going to do that twice. And then you're going to blow a six, draw a five, and draw a four. And that will be the main line you read as a new harmonica player. Underneath that, I have tablature for guitar and ukulele. And for those of you guys that know how to read that, that's super handy. And then finally, I think the other thing to know is what's going on the website, generally speaking. So when you come to the website, mammothgardens.com, the front page, I use that for a launching pad for some of the other types of music I teach. And then, but the main thing, click on the girl that's dreaming of harmonicas. She'll escort you into our front page for harmonica ensemble. That will give you the daily schedule along with whatever sheet music we're working on that week. The other two pages on the website that are helpful, there's a harmonica archive. Everything on YouTube is recorded automatically, and so you can go through if you're bored and you want to play some music from one of the previous classes, just pull up an old archived thing and play from that. And then the other page on the website is a harmonica library where we are busily amassing all of the sheet music that we are doing. It says on there for the modern stuff, it says for members. If you want a piece of music that you don't have and it says for members, just send me an email and I will send that to you. Hopefully that'll get you started on playing harmonica and started playing harmonica as an ensemble experience. And then obviously come here every time we have a class and play a little harmonica, and you'll learn how to play ensemble. You'll also get pretty good at playing solo harmonica, and hopefully it'll inspire you to become a more well-rounded musician in lots of other ways as well. So that's it. All good to have you here. Off we go.